today I'm going to show you how to prepare sweet pork ribs. Aluminum foil, baking sheet, cutting board, knife, and a saucepan. Grocery items are onions, pineapple, and your pork ribs. Ingredients for dry rub is black pepper, cloves, cinnamon, and garlic. Ingredients for the sauce is bourbon, honey, ketchup, mustard, sriracha, and Worcestershire. Take two onions, clean them. You can use the red onions like I'm using here, or you can use Vidalia. Sweet onions work quite well for this process. What we're going to do is we're going to cut these onions and put them in the bottom of the pan to help not only lift the ribs, but also provide an area for the fat to go to so that the meat won't be soaking in the rendered fat. For the onions, you want to remove the tops and the bottoms and remove the outer layers. Think of them as the onions themselves. When they're cooked, they're going to kind of be sauteing in that fat, and they're actually quite delicious if you like sauteed onions. Here I'm going to do is slice them in half because it's easier to cut them against the grain when they lay flat on the wood cutting board. I like to have thick slices, probably a quarter of an inch. And I'm making more onions here than I need, but it's better to have too much and put it in a storage bag and not have enough. Grab your aluminum foil. We measure it against the ribs that you see up there at the top of the island in the pan. And make sure we've got enough. You need enough that it not only would cover the ribs, but exceed probably by at least half a hand length to either side, because you're going to be folding it up to contain the ribs themselves. We place the shiny sides so they're facing each other. And that will allow you to look at the top of the dull aluminum foil, and if you see any shininess across that top, then you know it's not perfectly lined up. What I'm going to do is take the first half inch and fold it over, and I do this carefully because the aluminum foil likes to move on you. And then once you get that first fold in, then you fold that fold over till it's like a quarter inch. Unfold it and place that in the pan. That'll be supporting the weight of our ribs. And start putting our onions in here. Like I said before, you need to put a sufficient layer of onions to help support your ribs. That way, it's not sitting directly on the bottom of the pan. This prevents the meat from laying in the rendered fat. I like to split my onions up, make sure that I don't have any more than two layers in any other, and that the onions themselves become kind of translucent. They become sauteed in the fat of the ribs themselves, and they gain the flavor of the sweet ribs. They're quite delicious if you end up salvaging those onions for later. We'll put on the dry rub now. This is our garlic powder. Apply ground cinnamon. And then black pepper. Like to score my meat. I see where the bones are going, and I like to cut the meat tangential to the rib bones. and that provides a way for those spices to get into the meat itself. Then I'll squirt in line with the bones. You don't have to rub in this dry rub, as the name implies. Being cooked for 2 hours, that those spices will get into the meat. The rendering of the fat will kind of bubble to the surface and then draw those spices back down. But this way, I make sure that those spices get in there. Oh, and I like to add powdered clove just on the surface. Clove is a very strong spice and adds a nice sweetness to the meat, but I don't like to rub it in because of the strength of the spice. Make sure your onions are underneath the rib itself. And we fold in the sides to cover the ends, and then we fold in the bottom of the top and form a seal across the top. And then we're going to place that in the oven for 350 degrees for 2 hours. Raw ingredients, I'm going to put about a cup of ketchup in the saucepan. You use honey mustard here. I'm just using French's. You're probably looking at about 2 tablespoons of mustard, probably about a tablespoon of Worcestershire. And then sriracha, no more than a tablespoon. I mean, if you like it a little hotter, then you can go more. But be careful, a little goes a long way. And these pineapple chunks, I usually like to get a whole pineapple, but I couldn't find one in the market today. So I'm getting the pineapple chunks. And all you like to do is add the juice to the sauce. And then I put it on the oven. I get it to the point where it's simmering, and then I will turn it back to low. After I get it stirred up, I add the honey, I add the bourbon. Unfortunately, I didn't have any bourbon with me today, so I actually have to use whiskey as a Jameson's. And then while the ribs are in the oven cooking, I like to keep that sauce on the oven top at least for an hour to create a depth of flavor. After about 2 hours, I'm going to take the ribs out. I had the foil actually sticking a little bit to the meat there on top. And you're going to take one end and you're going to create a spout with the foil. And that will allow you to drain off a mixture of fat and water from the rendered fat from the ribs. You want to drain the oil completely out. Otherwise, if you do, it'll stick to the aluminum foil. Now, I should have take the sauce out and put that on first, because that way I can get it evenly over the meat. Unfortunately, with me putting the pineapple on first, made it a little more difficult to get that sauce even over the meat itself. And then I'm going to throw that in there for another hour. And then after an hour, it should be done. The meat on these ribs basically fell right off the bone, and it was tender. Flavor profile is fantastic. I usually like to cut between every 2 rib bones to create like a serving size of 2 ribs per person. If you like to go singles, you can do singles. But that is how you make sweet pork ribs. Thank you for watching.